San Antonio, the bean and cheese capital of the world, it's the Alexander William Garcia Show with Jorge Infante Jr., Matt Brown, Chris Biasioli, and now, here's your host, Alex Garcia!
Been a long time. We have a great show for you guys. I have some fantastic guests. Can you believe it? For once, we have fantastic guests. I can't wait to introduce who we're going to have on the show. And anyways, our co-host is kind of busy. He's back there somewhere. Jorge Infante Jr., everybody. Let's give a great hand of applause for him. He's busy. He's probably, last I heard, he was in the restroom. And, he's probably still in there. Too much bean and cheese. Anyways, let's get with the show tonight, people. I have a great group of fellas here tonight. They're pretty wild and crazy, and they've been doing it for a few years. Musicians. They're rockers, man. They love to rock and roll. They love to party. The one and only tonight on the show, only here on the Alexander William Garcia Show, we have the Union Underground, everybody. Let's give a great round of applause, everybody.
What's up?
How you doing? Hello, guys. Have a seat. This is great. Awesome. Thank you, everybody. The Union Underground in the house. How you guys doing?
We're doing good.
Pat and Josh, welcome to the show.
Thanks.
Anyways, let's get started off here right away. Listen, I'm really happy for you guys. You guys are doing phenomenally great. You got a contract.
That's right.
You got a contract. Now,
the blood's drying as we speak.
The blood is drying. You got a record deal with Sony Columbia. Let's give them a great warm applause here. This is great. Union Underground from San Antonio, Texas, everybody. Got a big record deal. This is great. Now tell us, what happened? What you guys were jamming out and then you all just got signed? Or were you all planning this out? Or what was you all's plan of attack?
Well, originally, years back, about 94, 95, we started recording in our own studio. We started releasing our own cassettes for free.
Now, what's the name of this studio? Isn't it...
Studio Underground.
Studio Underground, okay.
And we eventually ended up recording enough songs for a CD.
Right.
So we went ahead and printed it up and did the packaging and everything. Next thing you knew, we had gotten a review in a few magazines on the West Coast through Music Connection magazine and a couple things. We ended up securing a management contract.
Now, getting back to the magazine part, does that really help a lot?
And you know, it's one of those things. It's who you know. The reason that we got that write-up is because one of our friends worked for the magazine.
Oh, okay.
To be honest.
That's the way it goes.
And next thing you know, we had a management contract, and the guy from L.A. who ran the management company said, there's no bands on the West Coast that have given me a CD like this at all.
Wow. So they were pretty impressed with you guys' material.
And they're like, San Antonio, Texas.
And you guys have been working really hard on this for how many years now? Not too long, actually.
Well, the band hasn't come to what it is until we started getting people like Josh and our bass player,
now,
Mike.
Now, Josh right here, what do you play, Josh?
I play the drums.
The drums.
I'm a drummer.
All right.
Sometimes the jug.
I could feel the vibe here of being a drummer myself. I knew you were a drummer.
we just sit a certain way. We tap our...
Yeah, you know, it's a certain look in our eye. I look at you and you got that drummer signal in the eye. It's a paradiddle eye blink. Something like that. Now tell me, Union Underground was another band before, right?
Well, actually, me and the founding member, Brian Scott, the singer...
Who's not here tonight. Brian Scott is...
He's elusive.
He's elusive.
Tonight.
Okay. Well, he's not here. He's another member. And the other member is...
Mike Garrett. He was the last guy to join. He's the bass player.
The bass player. Okay, cool. So before Union Underground, it was what did it start off? You guys had some arrangement together.
Well, we had something different. Brian was actually the other guitar player, and I was the guitar player. We had a singer, a drummer, and another bass player, and
on and on and on.
Yeah, you know, we started doing things, and pretty soon we started realizing that the member changes needed to happen, and the guy playing guitar needed to start singing.
Okay.
And before you knew it, we had a bunch of guys that were the same age and doing the same thing.
You tweaked it out and got something you...
As you know, just getting four guys the same age, the same mindset is a...
That is tough.
Do that, half the battle's won.
That's like doing a Rubik's Cube, you know? I'm trying to get all the colors at the same... That was pretty funny, right? Oh, well, something like that. Anyways, let's get back to you guys. Now, the plan of attack... Now you got a record deal. What's going to happen? What are y'all doing? Y'all are making the album or... did they offer you guys, hey, fly up to New York or fly to L.A. and we'll take care of you? Or
there was talk of that.
And then, but you guys said, no, we're going to stay home and do it home.
Well, the CD we had given them, they were so into it to begin with.
Right.
They freaked out on the CD so much.
Now, what was the name of this CD?
It's self-titled. It was just The Union Underground.
The Union Underground. Now, can we still pick up this CD?
We've actually pulled the copies of it. We have so few copies of it, we don't even have 100 copies of the CD left.
Oh, okay. But I remember I was in a... a Blockbuster, and I saw a lot of the Union Underground.
We sold crazy amounts here in town.
Right, so now we can't get one right now, just temporarily, right?
Not unless you're doing one of us, I guess.
And Josh?
Well, I think if you tap into the website, which we'll mention later, we could probably scrounge one up, but you gotta,
tap in
pretty early. Yeah.
Okay, you bet. I'll make sure that I'll get you guys a website in there. But, so now things are happening, and you guys are, I'm pretty sure you're up all hours of the night, not only producing, making this new album, but...
There's a bunch of legal business we're taking care of. As you know, we don't want to walk into some kind of record deal and go, okay, you have the right to use all our songs, take the tunes, you own the publishing, nothing like that.
Right, that's...
We're doing it right. We're not going to walk out of this thing with missing a limb.
You're going to making sure that everything's going to go smooth.
That's right.
Yeah, that's great. Now, when do you, what's your prediction? Like, when are you guys going to start touring and start... coming down on MTV, let's say, and start shows.
We won't be touring until early next year. Try to hop on some festivals or do a soundtrack or whatever
we
need to get our name out there. But for right now, it's just all writing and recording.
So the Union Underground is the Millennium Band.
That's right.
The Millennium.
The Y2K band.
The Y2K band of not only.
Something.
Not only for us proud San Antonians, that is, we're really proud of these guys, and we're really looking forward to, we can't wait. You know, everybody's sitting down, Union Underground, we can't wait till they come out with their stuff. Can't wait to go to their show. I can't wait to go see y'all in a big giant convention center and flick my lighter like the old times,
We're gonna do it.
And
you don't have to flick your lighter. We have a lot of pyro.
Okay, I'll just leave that to you guys.
But it comes out of his...
I'm going to ask some pretty personal questions here.
Okay.
What's going to be the name of the CD? Can you say that now or no?
We don't know yet.
I've got
a few ideas, but I can't
say
them
on air. Let's hear a couple.
Well, it'll be bleeped out.
Make up a funny one.
Yeah.
I don't know. How about Lesbian Nuns in Bondage?
Lesbian Nuns in Bondage. I like that one.
Something for the kids.
That almost sounds something like Felt Nun. That was a band called Felt Nun a long time ago. Anyways, but what we're going to do, did you guys bring anything for me? I know I can't ask for a CD yet. I need to go through the website on that. By the way, the website is union1@connecti.com. So if you can see right here on the screen right here, union, guys, we're going to have to point at the same time, union1@connecti.com. Be sure to reach the Union Underground's website. These guys would love to hear from you. Tap into them.
They got naked pictures of Pat.
They got naked pictures of Pat? You mean totally naked? Does he wear his boots?
Well, they're not spread cheeky kind of pictures, but they're...
In the buff.
So, girls and guys, tune in to the website for Union Underground. Also, we also have a video clip, don't we?
That's right. This is us playing at a place called the White Rabbit. We filled that White Rabbit to maximum capacity a number of times, I might say. And here's actually some clips of us doing that.
Unfortunately, I haven't been able to make it to a show as much as I wanted to. I play gigs on the weekend, so it's hard for all of us to, hey, come check me out at the White Rabbit. Damn, I'm playing. Yeah. And it's really hard. So on the Alexander William Garcia Show, we're going to show you a clip of Union Underground's, one of their videos. This is one of the, you know, this video is how old is this video?
Actually, this show is from February, last month.
Yeah. Oh, it's just, this is really recent.
Yeah.
So, you guys need to feel privileged out there because they weren't going to bring a video and they did. Let's give a great hand of applause. Union Underground, everybody. Let's go ahead and take it to this video clip. And everybody sit tight and enjoy. We'll be right back. Union Underground, everybody. Awesome. You guys, you know, after that video, I just want to go and... Right, everybody, Union Underground, thanks for coming out tonight. You guys are coming back, and next time you're going to jam on the show, you promise?
We will do that.
That'll be awesome. Let's give a great hand of applause. Union Underground, thank you guys once again for coming out to the Alexander William Garcia Show.
Thank you.
Yeah!
is Big Bob here speaking, and I want you guys to come on out to Big Bob's Bottle Buster and Barbecue Buffet. You can eat all you want, guaranteed to bust a bow now. Now, if you don't bust a bow, your buffet is guaranteed to be free. I'd like to see you try that, though. Come on down. Now, little Jimmy, get your little fanny out here and help me out. Tell these people what it's all about, Jimmy.
That's right, Big Bob. We got bow busting. We got ribs. We got spare ribs. We got pork ribs. We got chicken. We got all kinds of bow busting, fun here. Bow busting.
That's right.
Hang on. We need a bob and bucket at the exit of the dessert bar. Pronto. You hear all them satisfied customers?
I can hear all them satisfied.
You hear all that bob bucket? You hear that?
Did you just hear that one? Oh my God.
Granny Edwards, that's her third busted bow this week. She loves it here. Good to see you, darling.
It's like
you
I
keep
told
on coming
you.
Back.
Well, like I told you, come on out, Big Bob. Guaranteed bust a bow now. Jimmy?
Now, come on out to Big Bob's. You know you can't miss that delicious, tasty Big Daddy, Big Giant rack of ribs, pork ribs, beef brisket, sausage, everything is smoked to your delicious delight. Y'all come on in. You get some potato salad, coleslaw, ranch-style beans, and all the servings you can get. And don't forget, our lovely waitresses will be here to serve you over here at Big Bob's. Located down at 1604, make a right, you'll see a goat, and then you'll make a left, and you'll see a bunch of cows, and you'll be right here in Big Bob's. You all come on out now.
It's like I told you. You come out and see Big Bob, you're guaranteed to bust a bow now, I tell you. Come out and see me. Little Jimmy, get your little fanny out here. Tell these people. Come on out to Big Bob's.
That's right. Come out to Big Bob's and we're going to bust a bow. Everyone bust a bow. You had me some earlier. And I feel pretty good.
That's right.
Everyone comes out.
God, Jimmy, not here on TV. Now get your fanny out of here. I'm tired. Jimmy, get... Son, oh, God, Jimmy.
We're back. Yes, we're back, everybody. You know, Union Underground, man. Can't wait to go see one of their shows. Anyways, I'm going to get back with you guys. We do have another guest, and I was looking right here, and it says Clever Williams, and I was wondering who Clever Williams. I had to touch up with Jorge Infante, everybody. He's in the back there. Everybody, let's give a great warm applause for Jorge Infante. All right, great. Well, you know, you guys remember Jimmy Dugan, you know, the guy that I almost, well, I beat in basketball, but he was cheating. Well, anyways, Jimmy Dugan has an older brother, a long lost older brother. He hasn't seen his brother in I don't know how many years. And, well, we found him. We found Jimmy Dugan's older brother, and we invited him tonight. And, well, let's give a great warm applause for Clever Williams, everybody. Great. All right. Everybody, Clever Williams. Hey, Clever. Thanks for coming out. Thanks for
How
coming
you
out.
Doing?
Who? Hey.
Bram, man.
Right. Hey. God, welcome to the show, Clever. Was it a long trip? Did you have problems with the flight?
Well, the security cut me off. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I had to roll around my guitar.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay, I understand. Now, Clever Williams, you haven't seen your brother Jimmy Dugan in how long?
Well, in many a room, but we had a falling out, if you will.
Right.
When we was younger. Mm-hmm.
Okay, now this falling out, I mean, you don't mind me asking, what happened?
Well, you know how if you go out on the beach, on the prowl, you stuff your shorts in the front. You know what
now,
I mean?
If you're going, what do you mean by going out in the prowl to the beach?
Well, when you going around trying to meet the women, you put a something in your short.
I've never done that before. Nah. Have any of y'all people put something in your shorts at the beach?
All my brothers do that, including myself and Rasheem. But...
Hey, Rasheem, hi, by the way.
Jimmy got confused. He put the potato in the back of his shorts. I'm going to point it out there. Everything, yeah. I'm embarrassed. Yeah, my brother up there, you know?
Well, that's Jimmy Dugan is going to see this show. And Jimmy, I don't want you to be pissed off at me, but I found your brother and we're interviewing him. Now, whatever he says is totally...
It's the truth. It's true.
It's the truth.
All right.
It's the truth.
It's
now,
the truth.
What do you do for a living?
Well, I'm kind of like the instigator, prosperator, interrogator of the women at large. See? Kind of like, I take all the women, and I kind of walk up when I meet them, I'm like, baby.
I get you. Okay, that's great. Now, is this what you really do, or are you just joking with me?
Nah, I do that. Well, I'm also kind of like a Don Juan Demarcus with the women as well.
Okay, I get it. I get the picture. But Jimmy was bragging that his older brother used to play music and that he left. Now, is it true? Jimmy Dugan said that you left him as a child because you went on tour with a band. Is that true?
In parentheses, that's true. But I had the wind up and the hoe down.
Now, what is the wind up and the hoe down?
Well, it means I was playing a song for my ladies, like this one right here.
Okay. What's her name? Ashim or Rashim?
Rashim. That's
Rashim.
Her name.
Okay, now, look. Everybody wants to know. We hear you're pretty talented.
Well, I've been known to kind of entice the ladies into a wow orgy.
Now look, orgies are fun. I don't know that, but I heard. But I want to know how you entice these people. Does everybody out here want to know how Clever Williams entices women to orgies? Come on, people, let's hear it.
Hey, all right, hey.
Now, Clever, show us how you do it.
Well, first I go like this. I see a woman, I go, babe.
Right?
Yeah. I give a song.
Okay, let's hear it.
I'm Clever the brother.
Okay.
And come to Clever Williams. And I roam. Come to Clever Williams. Mm-hmm. That's me. That's how I do it.
That's how you do it. Let's just give a great hand of applause for Clever Williams.
I did it.
Okay, we're going to take a quick break after these messages. We'll come right back. Thank you, everybody, for sticking around. Woo. Wow, Lee, that's great. High five or something there. That's great.
Hello, Alexander William Garcia here, traveling. As you can see, I'm in a car with a couple of really cool dudes. They're professionals, and I'll tell you that in a little bit. Right now, I'm just here on the road, and today's topic is storm chasers. You know, everybody's been hearing the tornado mania on the news, so what I did was I wanted to go out and, hey, let me go talk to these fellas who chase these storms and tornadoes and find out what kind of life these guys have. Storm chasers, what do? You hear them yelling on TV. You hear them screaming, tornado! You hear them screaming all that, but that's all. That's all we know about them. You've seen them on Twister, but that's not enough. And you're going to know more only here on the Alexander William Garcia Show. So I'll be right back after these messages to interview the Storm Chasers.
An alto cumulus precipitative downdraft over there. What's your opinion on that, Marco?
Well, it looks kind of like a cumulus.
You see the kind of swirling winds over there. It seems a bit of a...
These are like some buttermill events right here.
Yes, I agree with that. Or no, do you think that'll turn into anything, or...?
We've got some positive and some negatives.
That warrants a closer observation on that. When we get the precipitative the alto cumulus factor on this.
And as you can see up front, the storm chasers are analyzing the weather. There's a lot of precipitation going on. Let's get back to the guys. Let's go ahead and let me introduce you.
We got some activity.
Let me go ahead and introduce you to the guys while they're here analyzing the weather. All right, here we go. Guys, don't mean to interrupt. How are you guys doing?
Hey,
how you doing? Your name is?
How you doing? Chrome Sack. Rocky Chrome Sack.
Rocky Chrome Sack, okay.
Professional storm chaser.
And you have your assistant right over here. How are you?
Fine.
Great. Your name, sir?
Rod Storms.
Rod Storms. Now,
electromagnetic discharge over there.
Did
3 o'clock.
excuse me, sir, but did you make up that name, or were you born with that name? You're a storm chaser. You did that on purpose, or is this coincidence?
Everyone thinks that because my name is Storms, that it's like some kind of, you know, made up thing. But I was I was born with the name Storms.
Precipitation excellent, increase. Excellent. Precipitation increase coming on.
Okay.
We're gonna have to chart this one. We're gonna have to chart it.
Well, we have here, we have a scenario, and we're going to go ahead and let Rocky Chromesack and Rod Storms take over as they look for a storm or a tornado.
Funnel cloud sighting right over there. Ooh, 2 o'clock, 2 o'clock.
Oh, ooh.
No, it's just a plane. Never mind.
Oh. You're always doing that
hey,
to me.
Just being, hey.
You know, I get excited when I do that. When you do that.
Better safe than sorry. We're so saving lives here. The National Weather Service is paying us for this service.
But you
have to take our job seriously.
You know how excited I get when you do that?
I know. I know.
Listen,
honey?
If you don't know for sure that it's one, then don't do it.
Okay, guys, now, you guys live on the road. Do you guys...
24-7, 365 days a year there, Alex.
Wow, that's excellent.
We chase storms. If there's something going on and it has to do with the weather, we are all over it, like a duck on a June bug.
Right. Now, have you guys chased anything lately? Have you seen anything, spotted any tornadoes? What is your wildest experience?
Doing this job or in general?
Just in general, as a storm chaser, you
Oh, okay.
I've done some pretty wild things, you know.
As far as storm chasing, we had a double twister down in Tornado Alley up in Oklahoma. That was back in 96.
The twin sisters, they called them.
Yeah.
Oh, God, that was a mess.
That was
awesome.
Right.
Awesome.
So,
really lost the old Dodge on that one.
You know, people die from these tornadoes, and
yes,
they're devastation. They're disastrous, but you guys seem to like it. I mean, you guys seem to like, you see a tornado, and you guys just pop off on... Happy fun.
It's a rush. It really is. If you've never experienced the true sensation of a storm, you know, it's just sizzling through the sides of the mountains. And the
you know what they say, Alex? If you don't enjoy your job, you know, I mean, why even get up in the morning?
Exactly.
We enjoy this. Me and Rod have been doing this for years now. The National Weather Service, taxpayer money, supporting this and funding our operation.
Right. Hey, guys, that looks kind of funny out there. There's some... Over here to your right, I'm looking out here. Oh my God. I saw one.
God.
Atmospheric pressure buildup up over there.
Oh my God.
130.
You see that?
130.
Oh my God. Ooh.
You guys find
something? Oh my God. Hey.
Something.
Get the camera out there.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Oh my God. Get the camera out.
That is an F-14. Oh my God. I've never seen
one so
big.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. Pull over.
Oh my God.
Ooh.
Series 4. Series 4.
It's a tornado.
Oh
my God.
It's a tornado. Russian gas.
Tornado on the ground!
Oh my God!
Run!
Oh my God!
Run! 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 Run